everybody welcome, come in, kneel down and pray.
Hello, hello everybody. This is Dennis Allen. You're listening to the Dennis Allen City Boy Homesteader Podcast. A podcast about a city boy who gave it all up to find happiness, financial freedom, and a better way to live life. Together we can learn and accomplish anything. Today is Friday, March 29th, 2019. And it's a podcast about the difference of just one aspect of our lives. You know, something you could all, I think, is a big problem in our lives. Road rage, stress, driving, commuting, things like that. Right now, I'm driving. I just drove through Bald Eagle State Park. And that's the park that kind of surrounds me out there in Woodward. And I got the cruise control on. Or I did. Now it's not on. Now it's on. Oh, I'm speeding, so I'm going to slow down. I have it nice and simple, and I'm just going to compare in three steps. I'm going to, first segment is going to be me driving out into the city. That's what I'm doing now. And then I'm going to film a segment of me driving out into the city, being in the city and getting closer to the city. Let's do that. I'm just doing this one on the fly, folks. Just bear with me. And then the last segment will be me back, coming home, back to the countryside. So I think it's going to be interesting to see the difference in the tone of my voice, probably the way I talk, things like that. I don't know. Maybe it won't. Maybe you will see a difference. I'm also videoing this. That's why the clarity is not going to be the best, because it is a video on a cell phone. I don't have my fancy microphone out, so... But I think it's going to be mostly okay to listen to it and to watch it. Could be kind of interesting. So if I show something like that bar, it won't make sense unless you're watching the video. So that's it. So that's what this podcast is going to be about today. So stick around. It's going to be a very fun day. There's a Jeep. I can't wave to Jeeps. I'm in the minivan. So, before we get into it, let's talk about our first sponsor. Sponsor of the day is Quarry Fest. Again, this is going to probably be... I'm going to be talking about Quarry Fest from now until April 20th. That's the day of Quarry Fest. And then I'll definitely be doing some kind of podcast or something for that special. Quarry Fest is an all-day music festival from 11 to 11 with vendors. We just signed up a new vendor today. Well, we're trying to. Not a hippie. Still not a hippie. Something like that. She makes all kind of like lip balms and things like that. Rusty Rail is going to be slinging the beer. They sent a whole tent. They're sending two people. So they're going to be doing that. IngleBean is going to be there. A couple other people selling food. Valley Girl Sweets is going to be there. She's a local, a gluten-free pastry chef. She does all kind of cakes and things like that. So it's going to be a great time. There's a GoFundMe, GoFundMe.com/Quarry-Fest. Or you can just search GoFundMe Quarry Fest and you'll find it. Also QuarryFest.com. And you'll get all the information there. So, woo! Let's get into it. Here we are. So right now I'm driving into a town that had a big controversy with the police. So see that speed limit? The speed limit here is 35 miles an hour. I'm gonna set the cruise control to 35 miles an hour. Bloop. There's somebody behind me that wants to speed. So she's not gonna be able to speed, especially through this town, because they give tickets if you're doing a mile an hour over the speed limit. It was, I guess, something that I think a lot of towns in this area should do, because it's a big problem. Like, and when you're in Woodward, there are speeders, you know, people coming from the city or going to Penn State. They all want to speed and zip through towns, these smaller towns. So I think, you know, some enforcement is necessary, whether it be neighbors out there with bats, like smashing people's mirrors if they're speeding through towns where there's kids and everything. I don't really want to get the government involved, but, you know, police are out there, so they should be monitoring speeding, you know. It's something I did learn coming out here, is just to use cruise control and enjoy the drive. You know, very beautiful scenic drives out here, so why not enjoy them? I don't know. So this town, you want to just cruise control it. Someone just called, sorry. This is live recording, people, from my cell phone. Hope it's coming out okay. So, yeah, I got hills out here. I put the cruise control on. If somebody wants to pass me, they're usually within their rights to. There's lines on the road determining, I don't know if people all know that, but the pining knife is a solid line you can't cross. If there is a dotted line on your side, you could pass. So, somebody wants to pass, they're anxious, and they're having a very stressful morning. So they want to get by me as fast as they can. Maybe they're late for work, who knows? Maybe they're sick, if they're, you know, who knows what their story is, you know? A lot of times when I was in a city, somebody would want to pass me, and, you know, I'd already be speeding. So it's like, oh, you want to go faster than me? And you would get that built-up road rage, you know? And it was just a natural thing. And I, many of times, got into arguments and fisticuffs, things like that, and fights, because somebody wanted to drive faster, or, you know, thought they were driving better, or just wasn't paying attention, and they literally cut you off by mistake, and they want to fight you. And, you know, back then, I was the, you know... I would have said, sure, let us step outside, put our boxing gloves on, find the gym, and throw down. So, out here, you know, people are very courteous also when they drive. They, the whole high beam thing, when, if you're driving down a road and somebody wants to, has their high beams on, you just flick them in high beams, they say, oh, sorry, and they shut their high beams off, and everyone's happy, you know. No one's driving with high beams blaring in their face on oncoming traffic. In the city, people just flick their high beams on and just drive with that, you know, even though there's street signs everywhere. It's amazing. So, this is my commute. Nice and simple. Cruise control on. I got my slippers on. When I take long distance drives in my minivan, I'll put my slippers on. So it's nice and comfy. I have my lamb skin or fur, I guess the sheepskin, you know, which the fur is still on it. So I sit on that, it's nice and comfy, and I just enjoy myself. I put on podcasts. I actually will listen to my podcast sometimes. Actually, I usually listen to it after I record it. And, you know, I'll listen to other people's. Like, so this trip, I have a 4-hour trip, about 3.5 hours really. And I'll probably be able to get 2-3 good long format podcasts in. You know, maybe a Joe Rogan, maybe a Jack Spearco. I'll even sometimes put things on a YouTube video. And I'll put it in my little cup holder or, you know, air vent flippy thing. Set my phone in there. Not that necessarily I'm going to watch it, but if it's a conversation between like a Joe Rogan podcast or even like the Dennis Allen podcast, where you can sit here and watch me talk and look at the scenery around me if you're on YouTube. The scenery is nice, folks, by the way. Let me just cut it off real quick. I'm looking at just farms. Farms as far as the eye can see. There's a cemetery, there's a church, there's a mechanic shop, and then there's farms. Farms, farms. Oh, there's a little house. There's a big, oh, that's a new one. Oh, man. One of those industrial chicken farmers are over there. You know, you got the big hoop house thing. So we don't like those. Bell and Evans, I think they're organic, but see all those, they have little, like dog houses, and they have little cows in there. That's veal. So don't eat veal if it's from a factory farm, because what they do, they just take the calves away and they stick them in those little barns, you know? The farm next to me, his calves are raised with the mothers the entire time on the breast milk and everything, so it's better. They just have one bad day. I mean, that's the, if you're gonna eat meat, it's you know, if you feel sorry for the cow, well, let it die sooner than later. So I don't know. But farms everywhere. I'm pulling up into Mifflintown, so that's where Mifflinburg. Where they made Mifflins? What? I don't know. Was it Mifflintown? I know one of them where Rusty Road is. It's where they made all the buggies. So it's called like Buggy Town. I don't know. I have no idea. But I'm coming up to it. Little city. There's a traffic light. 35. I obviously observed that. Cops don't want to mess around down here. And there are people out here. A lot of Amish. So very stressless driving. I enjoy it. So that's pretty much the trip going into the city. I'm going to cut it off pretty soon. Next time you hear me, I will either just change my mind and want to talk about something else, or I will be approaching the city on 280 when it comes kind of, I guess, coming into Newark area, because before that is like my mother. She lives out West Jersey a little bit in the country, and so Route 80 is very big, and in the country there's nothing, there's no signs or anything until you get into around Newark. Then they still don't have signs or anything, or billboards or gas stations or anything on the highway, but everything off of it is just buildings and traffic and trains and craziness. So I'll be back in a second. Actually, it's going to take me 3 hours, but next time you hear me, I'll be in that area. And there's a cop right there. So did you see him? All right, guys, be right back. Welcome to New Jersey, folks. So here I am in New Jersey. It's still Route 80, so there's no billboards and not any kind of buildings or anything. But I do see that I'm still speeding, and people are flying by me. So the speed limit now in Jersey, who is speeding and who is not, has definitely increased dramatically. So right at the Pennsylvania side, getting into like the Delaware water gap, people start speeding, but here in Jersey, everyone's gone. Something I did notice a lot more of is just signs, you know, like Route 80 East, mile markers, big signs, bridge freezes before road, another mile marker saying East 80, mile 15.8, yellow and black kuvly things, stripes, I guess some people would call them. Another mile marker, Dan the Affordable Moving Van has a sign up. There's a swamp, that's nice. There's a little tiny one with a whole bunch of numbers, another mile marker. So it's just littered with signs all over the place. That's one thing I already noticed just coming into Jersey. You know, they literally, and the sign isn't just like 16.4. It's a big, long sign that says Route 80. Below that, mile, full word, 16, a line between that, dot 6. So instead of just having, you know, 16.8 in a little sign, now it's a big, big old sign, so. Only thing so far, you know, the scenery is pretty good, but the speed limits have increased. The New York drivers are definitely the fastest drivers. I've known that for a long time. Not faster than I used to be, but darn close. So let's get a little closer to the city. All right, so here we are. I just got onto 280 heading. It's not 80, but it's 280. They don't have trees, they have these big walls. I'm actually on the other side of it. I had to go take a twinkle, so I stopped off in a gas station. They don't let you go to the bathroom, so I went to a cafe. They let me go to the bathroom, but these are the walls that block residential homes like that from being right next to a huge highway. So, man, imagine living like that. At least in our town. Well, actually, we don't even put up a wall, so whatever. Maybe that's what the Trump wants to do, put walls up to stop the sound from coming into neighborhoods. Think that could be it? I don't know, folks. What do you think? So I'm gonna get back on the highway here. They'll put that there. And let's see what it's like driving around in the city. I don't even know if this is a two-way street, but it is now. If it's a one-way, I'm only going one way. If it's a red light, I'm gonna take it. Well, turn on red is okay. 28 east I wanna take. I see it right up here. So, a lot of signs up here now. A lot of aggressive driving. The speed limit here is an unsafe speed. If you're going to speed limit, people are going to crash into you. I don't know if that's 100% true, but they could. You're not doing the average. I think if you're not doing the average of the road, it's a little unsafe. So that's it. So here we are, 28 East. We are officially in, I guess, East Orange. Graffiti on the signs. There's a sign every 13 feet. Oh, wow, Whittingham Place. That's like Whitting Hill, but different. Valley Road. That's, are there valleys here? I don't know. Oh, I'm sorry about the buzzing. Shoot. All right, so I'm definitely more alert and just ready to go in my driving. It's definitely not a very beautiful vista right now. Just pretty much cement walls, cement bridges, and cement trucks. And every other kind of truck you could imagine. So, we're coming up to a lot of exits, parkway exits, things like that. A truck, US mail truck, just, I'm doing, actually 55 because there's traffic. And a US mail truck must have been doing like 60. Flying past me in the road. Maybe not 60. Yeah, 60. It's only, whoa, big bump to you. Potholes all over the place too. That's something you gotta be careful of, so. Woo-wee, look at all the cars. And the narrow, the roads get a lot narrower. Look, graffiti all over the place on the signs, Liberty State Park. Signs are getting narrow here. I see buildings all over the place and cement walls. What good is that? What good is that, folks? Stress, I'm doing 63 right now. Not that fast, but I am keeping up. The right lane, mostly exiters, they gotta go slow. So I'm gonna stop this for a second, see if the quickest way there, hold on. All right, here we are. We're, this is Newark. Newark, New Jersey. I think this is still 280. Yeah, it's still 280. And look at this. I mean, it's like a video game of just thousands, hundreds of cars. Just the shoulder is about a foot wide on one side, 6 inches on the other side. Beyond the shoulders is just guardrails and cement pillars. The sky is full of buildings. There's center of Newark. There's churches right next to the highway, train stations, New York City's in the background, airplanes landing into Newark Airport, all kind of crazy things here. Bridges, oh, we're gonna go over a drawbridge. So can you imagine on Route 80 then shutting a bridge down here? There's a drawbridge, bridge that everybody would have to stop for to get through that. I don't think it would have happened. East of 280, Jersey City. Here we are, folks. My 14.6, my sign going up, I think it's 153. It was found somewhere over here. What are the numbers over there? Now that I want to say it, they don't have any numbers. I guess they painted, wow, they did paint over them. Ah, that's funny. Harrison Ave, street signs there. So my 1.53, I believe that's the number, was found on the side of the road over there. Looks like they all have gotten knocked off. So I guess if some truck or anybody's trying to pull over the side of the road, they're getting stuck there. So here we are, driving through very fastly. Big open vistas. I see Midtown Manhattan, I see Lower Manhattan, I see Jersey City in the skyline, flying under New York. Newark Airport. The PATH train is buzzing by over there. That's PATH right there. New Jersey Transit is on this line too. Construction things. I've broken into a bunch of buildings over there. urban exploring style, you know, like going in with all the appropriate permits. And my eyebrows raised there. And, you know, did some urban exploring. Found some treasures, salvaged some items. Now they're just all just bare dirt. Here's one coming up there. Oh, wow, they're using it for landfill. Oh, that's so great. Oh, that's hilarious. So, yeah, that's all landfill. See landfills all over the place. It's crazy. I am definitely on high alert now. Cars flying every which way. They pass on both sides at all crazy speeds. This guy's coming up right on my hiney hole. I'm gonna give him a little toot toot. Don't pollute, buddy. You see what I'm saying? It's crazy. It's a crazy cooter. That van would have never passed in Pennsylvania. All that landfill. So, that's me driving in the city. I'll probably come back once I'm in the actual city. It'll be more calming, I would think. Probably not, because it's going to be traffic, but everybody wants to race to the next stop sign, so gotta love it. This is the bumper. I just got off of 280, and it's all potholes here underneath the bridges that the Sopranos are on. I used to do a lot of off-roading in here, so speaking about driving, my old Jeep, it was a Grand Cherokee. It was lifted about 6.5 inches. And all these, you know, swampland between the highways and everything. Who's going to build? There's big electrical towers running through here. It's mainly the railroad tracks and landfills that own that property. So we would go off-roading in there. There'd be a lot of four-wheelers. Guys in four-wheelers go there. And every now and then you'd get a knucklehead like me with a Jeep. It was a very nice, beautiful Jeep. Very clean, mint condition, full leather, heated mirrors, here, all leather interior, Grand Cherokee, and I butchered it because I wanted a Jeep that could go into the woods. So me and my buddy Louie, it was his birthday yesterday. Happy birthday, Louie. Or Wednesday, whatever day today is. I'm gonna be posting this on Friday. Today is actually Thursday. So I did say it's the 29th, but that's the intro, so I lied. So this is all the traffic-y. Like, I thought that was a cop. It's not. I would just keep filming if there was a cop over here. I don't think he would try to... Wow, new power lines going up. Oh, there's a cop. See, I just passed a cop. He was over there. And I think he looked at me because he was just... I made eye contact with him and I'm holding the camera out. So maybe even you caught that on the camera. So those are... abandoned buildings I've been into. They didn't tear them all down yet. Behind that location there, you can't really see it. You'll see it over here. There's just blank area now, probably because it's all toxic and over there. That big, that's the Gibraltar Rock, not the Gibraltar Rock, for Prudential. One of those companies used that when people were going into Manhattan. One of the marketing people was like, oh, that's the rock of whatever. That inspired him to do one of the assurance ads. That's the rock we used to drive around in when we'd go off-roading. All back through there was the funnest place. This guy is going to cut me off. Good for him. Did have a blinker. Probably not paying attention. Look at this. Look at the mayhem. How are you supposed to know this? I could easily navigate this because I put my driving mode back on city mode. So this is still the city boy homesteader, so I could still drive like a city boy. I could cut people off like the best of them. So, wow, all new power lines, new bridges going up everywhere. This is the bridge, or one of the bridges from The Sopranos. Woke up this morning. That's going to be another podcast probably. Yeah, I'm definitely going to do that. I'm going to go a little fast now. Just my time in Elizabeth with the Italians, if you know what I mean. And I'm not Italian, so I don't know too much. But beautiful bridge, you're gonna be tearing it down. They're building it. Wow, it's gonna be a drawbridge too. That's crazy. I thought it was just a taller bridge, so they didn't. Wow, they're planning some big things down here. Wow, it's crazy. Look at all. It looks like that bridge isn't being used anymore. Oh, that's a train bridge. So here we are. There's a cop up here. I'm gonna show you the cop because he's not gonna give a crap. Pop, pop. Which way do you wanna go? I'm gonna make I'll do the legal turn here. That's the Jersey City cop. See him right there?
Well, that's Kearney.
That's not Jersey City. I guess I'm not in Jersey City yet. Oh! I went the wrong way. I forgot I was going to my friend Michael's house. Which way should I go? I'll go straight. I'm going to go through Indiatown, through here in Jersey City in a second, but check it out. City driving with Dennis Allen. All right, so I figured I'd go down one of Jersey City's, well, formerly worst roads. Not worse in as far as potholes, but most congested. It's a Little India, and it's usually full of traffic. Left-hand turn going, people going straight, wrong ways, things like that. Just mess. Everybody trying to cut each other off. Everybody wants to go first. Nobody wants to go second, because second is just the first place loser, Ricky Bobby. So this is Newark Avenue, Little India. A lot of Indian culture around here. Great, great food. But not great, great driving. Like, people just making U-turns right now. On my road in front of IngleBean, people make a U-turn like this. There's no cars ever coming. And people cringe here. It's just normal. There's probably a cop somewhere watching this. Just be like, eh? Well, hurry up. If I have to go, I'll just put my lights on. Everybody move for me, so. Yeah, moving up 3 inches at a time. Just, there's art on the walls. Millions of different signs and buildings and cars double parked and getting and out of parking spots and traffic cones and all kind of jibber jabber. So definitely not pleasant ride. Like, you'd be going up into Woodward around along the creek road. My miles per hour is completely gonna change. I was gonna let that guy go. Look at that. There's art everywhere. So, completely, you can't just sit back, have a cigarette, or enjoy a pipe, and drive around here, because you're definitely white-knuckling it. So, that's the big difference about driving in the city. There's always a traffic light, or there's a red light, or green light, or yellow light that you gotta fly through. My mother taught me when I was younger, when we would go to New York City, and they had all those crosswalks, like, see, there's like red hands above the crossing walks. So if the red hand meant that it would say don't walk, that would mean you'd have to run. So if it said don't walk, you got to run across the street, because there's no such thing as stopping at red lights. I don't know, maybe that's why I'm so crazy. I remember my mother used to drive like a race car driver. I would always call her a race car driver because I was a little kid, and she would drive fast. So I guess that's why I picked that up. My grandfather, crazy pilot. He, my first time driving, great story, was in an airport parking lot. So coming out of the airport, we didn't fly or anything. Just, you know, you would check out Linden Airport all the time. And in the parking lot, I don't know how we got talking about it, but we started talking about stunt driving and how you could drive backwards and spin wheel, slide, and then go forward. And so I must have been young. I was definitely young, maybe 12, because I'd never driven a car before. I couldn't touch the pedals, I remember that. I don't remember what the heck happened. I don't remember, was I touching pedals? Anyway, that story is not important, that part of the story. Yuck, look at that. Crazy, just buses going three different directions of people. Look, people cry, look at that. They just have to go through each other. America. Oh, and then she's not gonna let anybody go. We're gonna go this way, that way. Ooh, it's great. Yeah, I love it. People are just going crazy all different ways. Look at this, people crossing. That guy's not gonna cross. Oh, he could have crossed. I could have let him go, but people behind me would hit me. The bus is gonna go, that's for sure. Ooh, there's sheriffs over here. They're the ones. Oh, there used to be buildings over here. A lot of buildings gone now here in Jersey City, but still a lot of traffic. Sheriffs directing traffic out of the courthouse. They usually, I don't know. I like the sheriffs around here. They're pretty fun, cool people. sheriffs in Pennsylvania, they had a standoff. Instead of just shooting someone, they talked them out of, you know, shooting up the place. So, good for them. Good for sheriffs. My buddy Wilbur, he's a sheriff. Bergen County, we're in Hudson County, so these aren't his buddies. But, alright, I'm gonna get to my buddies, get the scooter, and I'll be back in a second. Alright, look at that. I got the scooter. It's in there. Started right up. The battery's dead, but it kick-started right away. Brrr. Couldn't really ride or anything. Michael had to get on a very important business call. He is the CEO of Entohacked. And trying to save the world with composting. So, got that. Still in the city now. Got to get out of the city. Mad dash. It's 4:26. Rush hour is actually probably on us already. It probably starts at 3 when school gets out. So everyone's trying to run home. I'm trying to run out. I also picked up a black soldier fly larvae container right there. Put black soldier fly in there. They eat up the waste and they do what they got to do. So pretty excited. That's kind of what Michael does. He's taking black soldier fly larvae to eat municipal organic, not organic, but yeah, organic waste. Not certified organic, but anything that's not, that was living at one time, except for cellulose. So cellulose is kind of like your fingernails and your hair, so they don't really dig that stuff. So woo, all right 3.5 hours I'll be home, and pretty soon I'll be out of the city, so stay tuned. All right everybody, I am back. Whoop, I can't turn that off. I am back in Central Pennsylvania. I just got off of Route 80, so it's the, whoa, the easiest drive right now. Nice and dark. I was trying to get a sunset. I pulled over at a rest stop for a sunset, but I didn't get to see the sunset. I missed that one. Well, I saw a sunset, but it wasn't that great. Yeah, what a difference driving from being in the city. I mean, from the country to the city and then back to the country. You know, my nerves are calmer now. My shoulders are more relaxed. I feel much more at ease. You know, less stress. Stress is one of the biggest probably issues that you're going to have while commuting every day. You know, I used to commute maybe a half an hour, maybe an hour of traffic. Every, well, 5 days a week, 7 days a week, you know. So, being out here, you know, I got the scooter, as you can see it back there. Can you see it? I got the scooter. That's what I wanted to pick up. That's going to be a nice drive from my place to the cafe. It'll be a lot easier, a lot less stressful. I probably can't be riding my bike into the big city of Milheim pretty anytime soon, but I will be riding that. Not a problemo. So, pretty excited about that. Yeah. So, all the pollutants that I talk about, traffic and road rage and stress, that's another one. So, hope you enjoyed this podcast. It was kind of like on the fly. Figured that I'd do it since I got this long drive, 4 hour drive. You know, yeah, about 4 hours either way, both ways, something behind me, nope. So, hope you enjoyed it. If you could, if you enjoy any of these podcasts, please share them with your friends. Anybody in the Valley, on a Wednesday, we have the What's Up in Penns Valley podcast, A Cup of Joe with Joe. Mondays, we have the Music Mondays, pretty much anything music related. Right now, we're doing a lot of stuff with Quarry Fest and what's going on with that. That's a big part of my life right now. I am starting a music venue. Also, as you know, the IngleBean, we have a great open mic there too on Friday night. So please share these podcasts if you're enjoying them. If not, why did you listen to it till the end? All right, everybody, really appreciate it. I don't know if I'm gonna, yeah, there'll be a song of the day. What's the song of the day? It's a surprise. It's playing right now. And the sign said,
long-haired freaky people need not apply. So I tucked my hair up under my hat, and I went in to ask him why. He said, you look like a fine, upstanding young man. I think you do. So I took off my hat, I said, imagine that. Shot on sight. So I jumped on the fence and I yelled at the house, hey, what gives you the right to put up a fence to keep me out or to keep Mother Nature in? If God was here, he'd tell you to your face, man, you're some kind of sinner. Membership card to get inside.
Around the